Good evening, you two. Bill number three down here in the Carolinas. Down here in these tobacco fields. What we got up on the bench today is a box that a friend of mine, I built for him back in 2001 and the beginning of 2002. And he passed away and sent word that for me to come get one of these boxes back. That pretty much willed it to me, and I got to looking around and I got tried to find some paperwork of what the earliest paperwork I found I kept was some stuff that I bought back in the day. This ain't got no transistors on it. This is Westgate Laboratories. They used to sell stuff back in the day, and this is back in 06. Some of the stuff I bought then. And I don't think I bought no transistors on this one, but at the time I remember I was giving 18 bucks a piece for them. I got some a little bit older paperwork over there. I think it's 07. I think it's 18 bucks a piece for transistors. And with this box here, getting back to it. Like I said, he left this to me. Well, went and picked it up the other day. Thought I'd do a video of it. And I took a front off of it to look at it, see what I even put in it. It's a 2-driving 4. And it's got a variable power on the front and a switch. Let me take the cabinet off. We're getting back to the front. Let me get back to it. I like the way this front's made. It's swirled, that's what I call it. We used to go up and get some boxes made by Screwdriver, which makes Avenger boxes. He used to live up in Statesville, North Carolina. He built us a box one time, had a Ford-1000, and then he made it into two Ford-1000s, and then he made it into a 3x3. But he used to take and swirl his boxes like it's all over. And I always thought it was real pretty. I thought it looked like CDs laying over top of each other, or you know, where we used to TIG weld and, you know, roll the cup, and it looks like, you know, laid dimes over top of each other. Weld, we called it laying dimes out. When you made the welds look like you laid over top of each other. And we'd walk a cup and it would make it look like this in a way. I always liked that. And you, of course, see, he was a smoker. He had a towel laid over top of it, and smoke didn't get on it from here up, but from here down is smoke all over it. Smoke all around it, dust and stuff. And let's get to the inside of it. Turn that switch on that thing. This is a 2x4. It's got all Toshibas in it. Like I said, I made this back in 2001-2002. Still looks good. It's got Toshibas in it. It's two 2290s driving 2879s, and let's see. Yeah, set of red dots in there. The only thing I can see really scorched up on it any a little bit, took any heat, was the 1000s up on top of the output transformers there, and that 100 back there, it's a flame proof 2-watt. It's got a little discoloring to it, but ain't too bad. Still running. And it's a box inside of a box. I got two fans on top of it. And this box is broke out in 90 here, 90 back down. 90 back over here, a couple screws in it. And the way I got this amp made in here is this bolt goes up through here and holds it in there. A couple screws down the side. And the SO239 is mounted on the back of the heat sink back there. So I can take and just slide this out and do whatever you need to do to it, and then slide it back in and had to unhook the capacitors back out. The capacitors, got them at Shelby Ham Fest back then. And then just a little 3800s at 40 volt. And those big old cans there. Let's get the light on. Big old cans there. I mean, you can get them a whole lot more capacitance now and less the size. You know, you can get them this size now, or even littler than this. Way on up in the capacitance. Hell, 560, I think. 560,000 in a computer grade capacitor like this. This one ain't that big, but that's an old one too. But yeah, that's what it's got. And this is for the 50 amp rectifiers. And it was put on an old two-pill board. Took a two-pill board and stripped everything off it, and then put the rectifiers on top of it and put a nice little bleeder on it. And man, this ain't too good a job here, but it was done and it's lasted this long. They ain't never had no trouble. That's double stick tape around those wires going through there. And this is 21 volt feed-through after rectification, 21 volts floating. And this some of the transformers got from Westgate Laboratory. The 430 7001 transformers. They're supposed to be 35 amps a piece, and I have seen them pull up to about 90. About 90 amps is what was getting out of these, with a dropping down to about 13.8 on it. And yeah, this is a double stick tape. That's all I had at the time. To make a gasket for when this top goes up on that, the air don't escape. And up on the back is a piece of vinyl. It's sticky on one side because it's got air holes in the back, and put that vinyl up there to keep air from going out. So when the air comes in this box through them fans, it comes around and goes up on the heat sink, goes out the bottom of the case down there. And it's got a good area. Got some big tall feet on the front. Little shorter ones on the back, so it's, you know, at an angle. But you can get your hand up underneath that. It flows out good. And this here, I got to looking. This pink slip, a ticket I got back in the day. And I guess this was rubbing the side of the box a little bit. So I put that in between that so it wasn't rubbed. And you know, this ain't nothing but paper with shellac on top of it. So this, you know, probably wasn't the best thing to do, but it was in there. That's what I done at the time, just so it wouldn't rub through. There's my AC hookup parts and big nice cable coming off the back of it going out. And it has got a fuse link back there. Yeah, it's got a fuse link back there. And actually, I think I got this wire here. That's a fuse link. Got that fuse linked up in there too. That was two of them on it. Just something from back in the day. And she's still running good. Still running real good. Getting on down. As far as I've seen, I've put one little test run on it. We're going to put a test run on here in just a minute. A little 2x4. And the 2x4s I make now, well, make a 1x4. Because I think it, you know, shouldn't drive it that hard. So I put a 1-pill drive and a 4-pill with these HT transistors now. And they still do good. I ring back when I was making this thing, it, I took in, messed up on this side, so done the other side. You know, young, dumb. Oh hell, mess up. You got another side. Hell, why not hit the other side? Well, get this back up on here. I kind of like your little box. The box, the cabinet. I remember getting this from Trader Joe's down in Wake Forest, North Carolina. Went down there and got a cabinet, and like I said, we was getting from Westgate Laboratories, and at the time, I don't think it had any broke out boxes of, you know, of any size that I remember. I don't know. I got some paperwork over there, but I haven't went through it. Like a little catalog I used to send out. But anyways, we got this cabinet from Trader Joe's for like $5 or $8, something like that. So that's what we used. And this piece of aluminum right here, I used to work at D.H. Griffin and got this piece of aluminum I had to scrap for, you know, $3 or $4. So got a cabinet here for less than $12, $13. So we used it. Like I said, made a cabinet inside of a cabinet. And yes, it done good. Like I said, it's been running since he run it to passed away. And been doing a good job. And what we're gonna run it with today, same old test equipment. So noise canceling mic. I think it's a 636 noise canceling mic, Cobra 29. So all I did to it was turned up a modulation in it and put a variable key on it so I could dial my watts in, you know, go from hell a quarter watt on up to, I think it'll go up to about 5 watts on the dead key, so I can have a variable dead key for all these amps. So I think I got it set at about a half a watt. And let's see what this thing will put out. This is my reverse meter. I'm gonna turn around and forward. It's gonna tell you what's going from a radio out through the amp, through the bird, out through the dozy, back into the dummy load. It's gonna tell you what's going through there, feed through. Well, it's gonna show the watts coming out of the radio. Hello. It's a little bit more than 5. See what it is over here on the dozer. 20 watt scale. Good RMS. Focus. Hello. 5 on the old dozer. See what she'll do on peak. This is just a stock radio with a modulation turned up. Audio. It's about 12, 13 peak watts. That's all I got going into this. It's all running into it. That's my coax coming out from radio. Going through my line section now. I'm gonna turn around this. It's going to reflect through here. Then it goes through the amp. Comes out the amp. Goes into the Bird 43 with a 1,000 watt slug in it. It comes out of that, goes up in, goes to the old dozy. I know people don't like dozies. Yeah, it's stuck a little bit, but people don't like dozies, but it's just reading my peak watts. I go by this. That thing's putting out the bird watts, the peak watts will follow. This gatekeeper says. And we're gonna see what this bad boy's gonna do. Radio, turn amp on. Reflect watts, radio. Audio. Audio. About 1,100 peak. Bird, 1,000 watt slug. Audio. You see it touch at 400 there a little bit. I'm gonna say it's doing around 360 380, something like that. Audio. I'm looking through the camera, I ain't looking at the watt meter, so it looks like it might have hit that 400, but let's look again. I'm gonna look at the meter. Audio, about 380, 380 bird, 1,000 watt slug. Chopper, 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 chopper. Get on down, get on down. 4, 4, 4, 1, 1, 1, 1. It's doing pretty good. Doing pretty good. Chopper, 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 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Enough to get old, what's it called, saying chopper, chopper, chopper. He keyed down, he said chopper, chopper, chopper. Chopper, 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 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. They tried everything, 1s, 5s, 4s. I always like 4. 4, 4, 4. 1's pretty good too, but not everybody wants 1. I like 4. Get a big old 4 going. 4. Golf swinging. There we are. We really do miss you, Little Rock. Hope to see you one of these days. Back again up in that old, up in the sky there. We'll see you. But there it is. Box was made back in the day. Still getting on down. Boys, don't go out here and try to drive these things hard. Let that amp do that work. Just a little old radio doing, you know, this radio don't do many peak watts, doing about 30 peak watts. Set the dead key low, half a watt, watt. Let that thing swing on out. And she'll rock and roll for you a long time. She'll rock and roll for you a long time. I know these boys out here try to say, you know, I didn't design this. Oh, saying they did design it, but, you know, when I first got into this and first box I've seen laid out like this was a Dave May design. And I copied it. I ain't gonna bullshit you. I copied it. And she's doing good. Been doing good for years. I mean, if somebody else designed it, I mean, I don't know. The first one I've seen, I'm going by my experience only, was Dave May. I mean, I like Fat Boys. I like X-Force. Looks like I see a little bit more trouble out of X-Force than I do the rest of them, but it's a lot more people got them, looks like to me, if, you know, you see them floating around out there. But I don't know. I design my own. I run my own. But, I didn't design it. I'm copying their design. It's been working. Well, I mess with it. Something that works good. If they come out with something new, we'll see how that goes. But these old HGs has been doing good. I'm running the HGs. Got one 2290 HG. Driving 42879 HGs. And I've been doing. They've been doing good. I got a one before, this little one before here. It'll do 400 bird with this radio, with same radio driving it. I run 29s and no hopped up 29s. That this one right here, I think I do a little bit more than this one. This one here won't do a whole lot more. That's what I run. Everybody says it sounds good and clean, and it gets the job done for what I do. I don't talk a lot, but when I do talk, that's what I'm running, the one before with Cobra 29. And like I said, she's doing, that little box has doing 400 bird, 1,000 PEP. That's what I get out of it on my meter. And old school red dots, I'm getting about the same thing. Like I said, this radio right here will put out a little bit more than this one, not much more. Ain't all of them gonna be the same. I think this radio here put out about 7 or 8 bird watts and about 22 peak. That's all it'll do. Little Cobra 29, a little newer. I think this one's a little newer than this one. Yeah, it's 06. Because it's got that thing on the back of it there. Yeah, and this one ain't. So I'm thinking this is a little older model. Thank you, so. But anyways, there we are. Little box, built in a box. Ready to rock. Have a good one, Bill, number 3 down here in the Carolinas. Later.